Welcome to the Zen in a Moment podcast, where you can get relief from the mental suffering that our brains produce at times. My name is Zen Cryer DeBrook, and I'm here to share with you some wonderful tricks and tips and tools about using what I call your internal guidance system. It's something that you were born with. And if you're not familiar with your internal guidance system, or your inner GPS is another way to think of it, you can go to zeninamoment.com and check out a video there where I walk you through literally feeling what your inner guidance system feels like. So I'm going to be talking about the IGS, internal guidance system, today in the tips that I'm giving you. And so if you're confused at all, like I said, just go to zeninamoment.com and check that video out. Today I want to really go out to some parents with some ideas that I've created in my life to help me be a happier parent. And one of the big things in this tip I'm about to give you is realizing that parenting is one of the most difficult things in the world. You know, I'm a mom of a three-year-old, and the experience that I go through on a daily basis with how my mind thinks about my parenting, what I should be doing, how I should be feeding my son, how much time I should be spending with him, what kinds of things I should be saying, my temperament towards him, I can become pretty hard on myself. I call it the bad mom syndrome or bad parent syndrome. And I found that in working with lots of women and having lots of women friends who are mothers, we all go through it. We all go through the suffering and the pain of feeling like we're not living up to our desired parental goals. The pain and suffering of feeling like we are a bad parent. I was with a wonderful group of women the other day, and one of the women says, all the other mothers are just so much better at disciplining their kids and talking them through challenges that they have with other kids. I just don't know what to say. I just don't know what to do. And I know for me personally, I'm really hard on myself. I have to stop myself by using my internal guidance system. I have to stop myself from really getting down on myself about all the various beliefs I have about what a good mom is. And the thing that I want you to know is that these beliefs are not coming from whether or not you really are in the present moment being a good or a bad parent. In the present moment, the judgments that you're making about yourself and your parenting style and what you should, shouldn't, have to, must be doing in order to have your child be healthy and strong and resilient and joyful and all these things that they tell us that we should be producing in our children on a daily basis, those judgments are coming from past ideas that were handed down to you from your parents, or watching how you don't want to do it like your parents, and then all of the things that you've read and seen and how much you love your child. But in the present moment is where your happiness lies and the truth of how you're doing as a parent. Now, how do you get to that present moment? How do you leave behind these limiting beliefs and ideas? Well, you use your internal guidance system. The internal guidance system resides between the throat and the upper solar plex area, and it's where all of the stress happens. The feelings of constriction, anxiety, worry, fear, frustration, irritation, impatience, these kinds of energies, they actually are physically felt in the center trunk of your body. And what I've found is this is actually a guidance system. And so when I'm going about my day and all of a sudden my mind brings up some bad parenting thing that I'm doing, my kid was in daycare too long today, or I didn't give him a good enough breakfast getting out the door, or maybe I snapped at him because I was frustrated and impatient. As I'm going through those remembrances and awarenesses, I feel this suffering inside my body when it's not true. I mean, and it's painful suffering, but that closing, that tightening feeling in your IGS means that what you're thinking is not true. It means that if you're suffering with that thought of not being a good parent or not doing living up to your standards of parenting, or being hurt by being impatient with your child and seeing the look on their face when you're busy and you're racing to get something done and they're fighting you at every turn and stalling the process, right? That pain you feel means that what you're thinking is not true. When you do need to step up your parent game, you'll feel calm and centered and open. When I do have a thought that I need to really pay more attention to the probiotics that my son's getting, when he's on a, antibiotic for ear infection, I feel an opening. I know that I need to get on that. If I feel like I'm letting my kids stay up too late sometimes because I don't want to fight over it, and I feel a calm, centered opening, I know that's true. I need to get him in bed earlier. And so it doesn't feel like suffering. It feels like a calm knowing experience inside. I want to encourage you to go to zeninamoment.com. I hope you like this little tip. It'll clear out a lot of the pain. If you practice it and you on a regular basis, you can begin to release this pain of being afraid of not being the right parent, you know, the perfect parent. It'll get rid of your bad parent syndrome, and it'll also know what you need to get on, you'll be able to get on, because you'll really feel in your bones is something that's important for you and your child or children. All right, I'm Zen Cryer DeBrook. Thank you for listening to zeninamoment.com. This podcast is going out twice a week, and I'm super excited about bringing you these tricks and tips to help your life as a busy human being be better, more prosperous, and more joyful. In the meantime, until I talk to you again, I'm sending you love and blessings.